And welcome back to our Let's Play of Demon's Souls. I am Chevy Cheez-It, the latter half of Three Heart Runners, and today we will be fighting the final boss of World 3. As a Frozen Nord says, woohoo, sitting right next to me. Anyways, this is a really cool boss. It's actually one of the only bosses in this game that, if you play this online, you will actually fight another player online. Now, unfortunately, I'm not playing this online. At this point, you really can't play Demon's Souls online anymore. At least I don't believe so. From what I've been informed, that function has been shut down for Demon's Souls, not for Dark Souls. We get this cool little cinema here. But anyways, this is one of my favorite bosses. I think he's kind of a little easy if you're not playing against a player online. Especially if your character is as strong as mine is. But what isn't easy is actually getting up to him, because in the stairwell, you have to go up the spiral stairwell, kill a bunch of enemies, and then also when you get to the top, on certain points of the stairwell, our good old Cthulhu friends, our dark Cthulhu friends, are there to wreck our party, and they're a little bit more difficult to get close to, because the stairwell itself is extremely narrow, and there aren't many places where you can hide and dodge their magical attacks. So we'll see if I make it up or not. But anyways, this is the boss. And here we go. Set up. Like I said, narrow corridors, just obnoxious enemies. So we have to change up our fighting strategy here just a little bit. Now I know the pattern in which the enemies come, so I'm able to do this a little bit easier than what you might have to if you have never played this game before. But as you can see, I start walking slow, take out this next enemy here, and right after this we're gonna encounter one of our Cthulhu friends. And I mean, there are a couple of things that you can do. If you can draw him down towards you, it might make it a little bit easier, but I usually don't have any such luck, so I kinda have to blindly charge in and nail them. You can also use magic against them as well, but I don't have the magic to do that kind of a thing. So we're gonna enchant my weapon and just kinda hope for the best here. Here we go. And it worked out! Doesn't always work out that well. The other one. Like I said, it doesn't always work out that well, but I did kill him right when he killed me, or nearly killed me, so sometimes I get really lucky and most of the time I don't, especially in this game, so you count your blessings sometimes. Anyways, Alex is pissed off at the video game. We will do our quick spells here, the warding and the enchant weapon immediately, and then we will step in and go after this guy. Now, this is just a balls to the wall fight. Easiest thing to do is just be aggressive and go nuts, because as you can see, the amount of damage that I've done to him is just out of this world. Now, he has a tough little attack. He can stab you several times, and then he can also shoot multiple magic beams at you, which can do quite a bit of damage eventually. The longer you fight him, the more powerful he becomes. But I beat him so quickly that I couldn't even describe how to beat him. So, without further ado, that was the last boss until the final boss, so we have got one more level to go. I am Chubby Cheese, the latter half of the Three Heart Runners. Take care, you guys. I am looking forward to this final boss. Thanks for watching.